That's not going to work out for me. So how do you build this business if you're not going to be doing that type of building it in that way? Which you can do, which is absolutely acceptable, and you can succeed that way, but it just wasn't for me. And she said, why don't you approach it as a business? And I said, well, what does that look like? Well, how big do you see your business? And I said, well, I see it global. I saw it global from day one. I kind of saw myself as kind of like a nice Alexis from the Colby's or whatever it's called, you know, Dynasty, or like a nice JR or something like that. I kind of saw myself as a global leader and I with a skincare nutrition brand. So that's where I started off with, multi-million. And I started thinking, well, who would I put around my boardroom table? So I started thinking of people who are smart, who are successful, who are driven, who wanted better than their lot. And so I kind of dreamt this vision, this possibility for them and for me, for us to do together. And I started placing these people around my board, because if I want to create that sort of business, I need the best people. I wasn't looking for people who were like desperate, you know, who nearly needed it. I was looking for people who wanted it, desired it, which is a completely different energy. And how I worked was simple. I worked out, well, first of all, I had that call to my mother, and I said to her, I want to ask you a question. It's going to be a bit of a random one, but I want you to stick with me. She went on. I said, when's the first time you started buying mascara? She said, 16. And I said, how long have you gone without having a mascara? And she went, what do you mean? And I went, well, you've run out of mascara. And how long is it taking you to get another one? She went, are you kidding me? She said, I've got three on the go. I went, why do you need three mascaras? And she went, well, you never know. I went, what, do you think the great flood's going to come or something? She said, no, I've got one in the bathroom, one in the car, and one in my handbag. I need three. I said, is that a trend you've had for a while? And she said, well, yeah. So I said, and when do you see a day when you're going to stop buying that product? And she said, never. So I thought, okay, so you've been using since 16, you're never going to stop using that particular product, you've got three in a go. How often do you replace them? Every 2 months? And I went, ka-ching, jackpot. This is how we operate with personal care products, with loyalty to our brands. We wash our hair, shampoo, conditioner, we wash our faces, we shave, we clean our teeth, we put on deodorant, we put on our faces, we moisturize, we take nutrition. When those products run out, we rebuy. And we tend to be very loyal to one brand if it works or it fits within our ethos, our values, and our ethics. And if the product really works for us, that's what it says in the tub. Arbonne is that product. So when people start using the product, they realize how good it is and the benefits that they expect in the 21st century, but also aligned with the values that we've now grown up to appreciate. This is the real deal. Now the other aspect of that is, well, how do you make money? Well, it's simple in my opinion, is you turn that expense into an income. So the money that's walking out the door every month, every other month, the products you're already using, this was the key to me. I wasn't doing anything different than I was prior to Arbonne. I was taking a shower, I was moisturising and all the rest of it, taking my nutrition, and I was spending money every month, every other month on those products. I just switched my brand loyalty, and I decided to make this my business. I decided to become a professional consumer of Arbonne, a career consumer. So I turned the expense into an income. So the question I'd ask you is, would you switch your toothpaste, your skincare, hair care, whatever it is, would you switch those products for £30,000 per month on part-time hours? No?
Yeah.
I would eat it. Seriously, you would. If you could, you would. And that's what it is. So that's what I did. So I basically, all I've been doing since for the last 8 years is using Arbonne, turning the expenses into an income, and looking for business partners who'll do the same thing as me. Now the people who, not everyone's going to join the business, so say, well, who's going to buy the products? Well, I'm a consumer, I'm buying the products, and the people who say no to me, I'm showing them how they can buy them online at discount. So I create a consumer base by default of offering the business opportunity. The business opportunity can change your life. The four levels of success are district, area, region, national, vice president. Income's going from, well, zero, because if you start with zero, all the way up to unlimited income at the top. My personal average, my first paycheck was, I didn't get a paycheck for my first month. I started on the 28th of the month. But my second month, I got £6 or something like that, and I worked like a dog. So district manager, my average was around about £500. Area manager level, I was making about £1,500. I did this all part-time around another job, by the way. And my third level, regional vice president, I was making about £5,000. And I had a Mercedes-Benz, courtesy of Arbonne, and all the other bits and pieces we get. Oh, monthly, so monthly, yeah. And then at the top level is national vice president. The average is around about 15,000, and I was making significantly more than that, and have been for a number of years. So the business works if you do. It just depends how big your vision is and what you're prepared to do for it. I was really prepared to work outside of my comfort zone. And this was really easy for me because I didn't understand how Arbonne worked. So I'd never been in network marketing before. So when I was told what to do, I'm very task orientated. So I really felt uncomfortable, but I was going to do the job. And I see that in Lindsay's work as well. No matter what's going on in our private lives, we're still task orientated. And Lindsay, I was introduced to Lindsay as Lindsay Get It Done Ryan. And that's how I feel myself. I resonate with that as well, because ultimately we're going to get the job done. And when we make a commitment to someone, we're going to see that commitment through. So that's what I feel about it. Those are the four levels of income and success. But you need a driver. Now, when I was growing up, my childhood was a bit challenging. It was a bit weird. My father lost all his money. He was an entrepreneur, and we ended up moving to a completely different area. And he found solace in the bottle. And life was interesting, should we just say, eye-watering at times. And I remember looking at my mother, who became the main income earner. She took three or four jobs to put clothes on her backs. And she wouldn't leave my father for fear of stigma. That was back in the 80s, if anyone can remember what it was like back then. She wanted to stay as part of that family, keep the family together. And I remember as a child, like maybe 7 or 8 years old, looking at her going, I wish I could save you. You know, I wish I could take you out of that situation, but I can't make the money to change your circumstances. But I want to change your life, and I can't do it, know what's going on for all of us. And life goes on, and then we grow up, take our jobs, and we move to different parts of the country, etc. And at this point, my mum's now living where she's living in Ayr. And she's in social housing. And I was asking her recently, you know, how are things? How are things going? So there's a like October. She says, okay. But there's a family moved in to the area, and they're a little bit of trouble. And my father's now died, so she's living on her own. I don't feel comfortable anymore. And I went, okay. And I said, so she'd been thinking of moving, but she's not old enough to go into retirement home. She's, you know, young and fit and healthy. But she knows she feels uncomfortable at that age to be in her own. And I said, it's so funny, Mum, you talk about that because, you know, you talk about moving. Because I'm actually looking for an investment property in this area for a holiday let. And I'm thinking this might be the perfect time to buy. If you could come along with me, help me source this place, and you can help me decorate it, etc. So we found this amazing little cottage, two-bedroom cottage. It's in an area of outstanding beauty called Dunure in Ayrshire. It's by Clane Castle. It overlooks the Firth of Clyde, and you can see Arran. It's like the picturesque, perfect holiday cottage. It's incredible. I mean, you'd be so happy there. And so we found that, and said, well, this will be the investment then. So I said, you might as well help me get all sorted out. So she helped me decorate it. We got all, you know, how to do that. It was built specially from scratch for me. So in November, I flew back. I was going to visit somewhere else. And the house, I completed on the house. And I went to collect the keys with my mother. And she said, so what are you going to do? So we drove up to the house to see you. She said, so what are you going to do with it? I said, I'm going to give the keys to you. And people, the reason I've been doing Arbonne for all these years was to give me the possibility, the option to change people's lives who are important to me. So in that instance, I was able to buy the property, get a mortgage on the house, but I bought it there and then for my mother to give me the peace of mind that I'm looking after her as she gets older, that she looked after me when I was a child. So you're always looking for a driver, a reason why. Why would you do this business? Why is it worth fighting for? And for me, my family are worth fighting for, and I'll do anything I can to ensure they're happy. And if it's down to money, if money is the only issue to your problems, and someone's giving you an opportunity to create money, then it's not a problem. And that's the way I look at it. And that's one of the reasons that I do my Arbonne business. So I want to leave you with a little story. And I do encourage you to join Arbonne, by the way, it's fantastic. I want to share this. Okay. I'm a tennis fanatic, and my tennis coach gave me this recently, and I thought it was just perfect for those who are considering a change of life. If you're wondering if this is the right time, this might be an affirmation for those who are thinking this is the right time for a change. And my coach is actually descended from the Hopi Indian, the Native American Indian. And this is what he shared with me. It's a story that he passed down from his family. And I was telling him about Arbonne. So you've been telling the people that this is the 11th hour. Now you must go back and tell people that this is the hour. And there are things to be considered. Where are you living? What are you doing? What are your relationships? Are you in right relation? Where is your water? Know your garden. It is time to speak your truth, create your community, to be good to each other, and do not look outside yourself for the leader. Then he clasped his hands together, smiled and said, "This could be a good time. There's a river flowing now very fast. It's so great and so swift, and there are those around who will be afraid. They'll try to hold on to the shore. They will feel that they are torn apart and they will suffer greatly. No, the river has its destination. The elders say we must go off the shore, push off into the middle of the river, keep our eyes open and our heads above water. And I say, see who is there with you and celebrate. At this time in history, we are to take nothing personally, least of all ourselves. From this moment that we do, our spiritual growth and journey comes to a halt. The time for the lone wolf is over. Gather yourselves. Banish the word struggle from your attitude and your vocabulary. All that we do now must be done in sacred manner and celebration. We are the ones we've been waiting for." Thank you very much.